Yeah, this is actually a 6-1 no pads at the NEC, and they've all been building up, and this is by far the biggest we've got in here today.
How's it actually going so far?
Brilliant, it's been great, you know, I mean, they all seem to get bigger and better every time they do them. This show, we've got 522
really?
Dealer tables each day, which is incredible. We're now by far the biggest in Europe.
Really?
And we're in the top 5 in the world in terms of shows to this kind, so...
I-E-U-A-N. With lots of them, yeah.
I hope you can see this, but we've chosen gold.
It's great, it's great.
Here we go.
These cards away.
I'm picking them up before they go out, actually.
So basically, it's the NEC Monday, and you can come along and have any of the stuff that you've got.
Yeah, it's actually tomorrow and Sunday, from 10 o'clock till 5.
Sorry, 10 o'clock till 5 the weekend.
And it's only £3.50 for adults and £2 for kids. And as I say, it's an antiques roadshow for modern collectibles. There's free valuations from the top experts in Europe.
Okay, Birmingham NEC.
Yeah.
Good stuff. All right.
Thank you.
Lovely accent.
Well, it's a Scottish accent.
I know, but what part of Scotland?
Glasgow.
Well, more of that later, but joining us now is Henry Cook, who organises Memorabilia 98, Europe's largest fair specialising in modern collectibles.
Yeah, but never mind him. I'm sorry, but Batgirl is trying to fight her way through here. What are we going to be seeing there?
Yeah, well, basically, shows on this weekend at the NEC, we've got 638 dealer tables from areas like film, pop, science fiction, cult TV and comics.
Right.
And it's by far the biggest in Europe.
Yeah.
We've got Yvonne as our special guest across. And we'll have about 15,000 fans.
I'm here at Memorabilia 95, which is Europe's largest collectible event. And whatever you collect, you're bound to find it here. They've got everything from Bond to Batman, Star Wars to Star Trek. They've even got this Judge Dredd stand. You two could end up with Sly Stallone's bike sitting in your living room. Yes, I know, I'm nothing like him. But the proud owner of these fine gentlemen and the creator of the whole show is Henry. Now, there are no prizes for guessing what you're looking for today.
Absolutely. George Harrison's a missing member of the Fab Four I'm looking for. As you can see, Ringo's looking a bit gloomy. So if anyone around there can help me find George, I'd be very, very, very grateful.
No. Collectibles, and neither does Catherine, but we both know someone who does. He's the king of the bubblegum wrapper. He's Henry Cook, and he's here. Hi, Ken.
Hi,
thanks very much for coming here. Really? Why bubblegum wrappers?
Oh, just lovely artwork from them. You know, they're very colourful, and they're still quite inexpensive to buy when you do come across them, which is quite difficult.
Yeah. What have you got for us?
I brought a few selections of some of the old ones and some of the new ones. The first one I'm looking at is a 1966 Batman wrapper. This is quite hard to get and it goes for about £20. Very, very colourful.
Henry specialises in Beatles memorabilia and has spent a small fortune building his Fab Four collection, but it's been worth it. For believe it or not, these waxwork Beatle heads are now worth £8,000 each. This bass guitar, similar to the model used by Paul McCartney, goes for £3,000. And these Christmas flexi discs, given away free to fan club members in the 60s, now fetch £150. And an empty pack of Yellow Submarine Sweetie cigarettes will get you £200.
I've got things like three original suits, I've got some of the waxworks.
And I mean, you've got a plastic Beatles guitar, which presumably some kid would have bought back in the 60s with her pocket money. What kind of price does something like that fetch now?
There's two types. There's an orange one and a sort of a light yellow one. The orange one boxed is now making about £375. The yellow one, considerably less, maybe about £120, £140. It's a lot of money when you think that toy cost, you know, £7.60 or, you know, £5 at the time. So it's, you know, it's gone up a bit.
But pride of place in Henry's collection goes to a piece that's instantly recognisable. His Captain Scarlet puppet from the original TV series is an absolute work of art and worth a cool 25 grand.
There was only 9 of them left, and this is one of them. And it came up and I managed to do a deal for the guy. Spent a few quid on it, but it's nice to have. It's one of these things, you only get one opportunity on it. If it comes up, you won't get that phone call next week or in a year's time. So, yeah, right, that's when the pressure's on. You think, should I go for it, should I stretch for it? And you do go for it.
I looked at him like...